Hi, I'm Ann from the Chocolate Bells, and today I'm going to show you how to make our lovely basket of strawberries that we have here. Actually, I'm going to show you how to make the basket. Strawberries are real easy to do. Now, this is the mold that I've used. Okay, it's a large basket mold, and it has a handle on it. It makes a beautiful presentation for any kind of centerpiece on a table, a gift for a teacher, a gift for somebody's birthday. It's really a beautiful mold. Okay, but the only thing is you have to prepare this mold. Now we have to take and we cut the basket part off and we cut the handle off, and then we have to take that and prepare it so it looks like this. So now we have the basket mold. This is the base of it. And I have, now I've clipped this together already. I'm going to take it apart to show you what I mean. Okay, take these little clips off. And we use the bulldog clips on this mold. So what I've done is I've cut it out. I made it go down a little bit so I can get my clips closer. And the same thing here. All right, both sides. But I've made a hole in the bottom here. Now you need that hole because that's where we're going to put the chocolate in. So you're going to clip this together. You take your bulldog clips, or these binder clips actually. You can use bulldog clips. You can use a strong paper clip of some sort. All the way around, clip this. It's not hard to do. It's hard to open the clip sometimes, but not hard to do. And then you take, and I try to get in here and do a clip over here, and maybe one over here. Let's see. Fingers. They don't like to work sometimes. Get that in there. Okay, so now we have it clipped together nice and tight. Now this part I like to do first. I take this piece and with a melted chocolate in the squeeze bottle in that hole, I'm going to take and stick the tip of the squeeze bottle in there, and you can squeeze in the chocolate. You can see how it fills up around there. Keep squeezing till it fills all the way up to the top. Okay, then I like to go over here on this side and squeeze some more in so it fills up evenly, less air pockets. And squeeze that, fill it all the way up to the top, and over here again, get the rest in there. And then I look to see if there's any air pockets, I give it a little tap, and then this goes, I like to stand it up, this part I can't harden in the refrigerator. It usually takes about 10 minutes or so, maybe 15 in the refrigerator. You just have to watch it. Don't put it in the freezer because it tends to crack if you leave it in a little bit too long. Okay, I'm going to give that to Johnny. He's going to put that in the freezer for the refrigerator rather for me. Now over here I have my melted chocolate in the pitcher that I have here. And this is the base, and all we're going to do is we're going to take that, we're going to pour it in here. Now that was 2 pounds of chocolate in this pitcher. So you can see that this is going to take about a pound and a half of chocolate to go in here. So you fill that up. Okay, now I give this a nice hard tap, because sometimes there'll be air pockets stuck down the base over here. So you want to make sure you tap it down nice to get all those air pockets, because otherwise you'll wind up with little holes on the base. Okay, and John's going to put that in the freezer, and that takes about 20 minutes in the freezer. Now I have a set that's already done over here. You can see that it's already pulled away from the mold, ready to come out. So we're going to take this and we're going to just turn it over. If it sticks a little bit, sometimes I give it a little shove right in there and it'll come right out. There you go. And I have the handle. Now you can see the handle has pulled away nicely from the mold. The chocolate has. You take these little clips off. I always take my fingers and run all the way around here a little bit so that if there's any little pieces of chocolate that have overdone a little bit, because it always seeps through a little bit, it breaks those off and it prevents you from, eliminates the trimming a little bit. Okay, so there's our handle. We take it out and you're going to see it's going to fit right in there. Look at that exact fit. Okay, so what I do is I usually put a little mark right where it is, and inside with my squeeze bottle I'll put a little melted chocolate there and over there, and then I take that and I stick it right back in where it was.
Now you let that set and it's going to harden. Make sure it's straight. It'll set up and it'll harden. And then you can fill it. Now I have some pretzels here that I'm going to fill it with. You can fill it with the strawberry like I have pictured there. Ideally, I would let this harden first before I filled it, but just so that you could see what you can do with it. I like to fill it up with some nice little pretzels. These make great gifts for the teachers. Nice for anyone. You just fill it all up. You can put it in a cellophane bag, wrap it up. Looks really cute. And it's a very nice gift for any occasion. If you need the mold, we have it at thechocolatebells.com. Check us out. I like to use the Merkin's compound wafers, and they taste great and look wonderful. Have a great day. Happy candy making.